Good afternoon all. The next important topic in canals and reservoirs is Kennedy's theories and Lacy's theories. Kennedy's theories and Lacy's are Kennedy and Lacy are both the engineers in India. Kennedy is the engineer in Punjab, whereas the Lacy is the engineer in Rajasthan or UP. Why they proposed the theory is, usually in canals, you all know that there are two types of canals, one is lined canal and unlined canal. In unlined canal, there is a problem of silting and scoring. Silting means silt deposits. What will happen? Whenever the forces in the water, now the water force is at high range, the velocity of the water is high, the sediments will travel from one part to another part through the water. What will happen? The silt will deposit. The movement of silt takes place from one place to another place. So it leads to the silt deposition, and another one is scoring. Scoring is nothing but somewhat like, we can call it as erosion. We can call it as erosion. As I said, in canal there are of two types. One is lined and unlined canal. Both the theory has been proposed for unlined canal. The bed surface of the canal is unlined. Usually, the bed surface of the canal is usually unlined. For that unlined canal, both have been proposed the theory. One is Lacy's theory, another one is the Kennedy's theory. First, it was proposed by Kennedy. After that, whatever the corrections or whatever the limitations that has occurred in Kennedy's theory has been slightly altered by Lacy's theory. Kennedy is an executive engineer in PWD department in Punjab. He has done a research that what will happen whenever the velocity of water is more, there is a chance of eddies formation at the surface. Whenever the velocity of water is more, what will happen? The eddies will formation. Whatever the particle at the bottom, it will lift up and it will float at the top. Whenever the velocity decreases, it will settle. Whenever the velocity decreases, at that time the particle will move from will move for certain distance. It will also leads to silting. At some place the silt deposit will take place, and some place whatever the bottom of the surface of the canal will get damaged. To prevent this, he has to design the bed slope for if in which velocity if we supply the water, the canal will be safe, and on which slope we should provide the canal. What should be the slope of the canal such that it should undergo minimum silting or minimum scoring. Both the theory has proposed to find out the mean velocity and side slope or longitudinal slope. One is to design the velocity. If you pass the water at this velocity, the canal will be safe. It will not undergo silting and it will not undergo scoring. And what should be the slope? What should be the range of slope? Has to be designed by using these theories. S is the slope and V is the velocity. Has to be designed by using both the theory. Kennedy's theory have more drawbacks, whereas Lacy's theory has less drawback. Now we shall not undergo in detail with respect to these formulas. I will generally before these formulas, we shall solve one problems regarding Lacy's theory. Okay, first V naught is nothing but the critical mean velocity. Velocity, it is nothing but the velocity is I. The velocity is critical. V naught is equals to 0.55 my power of 0.64. Here m is the critical velocity ratio. Critical velocity ratio. M is equals to V naught by V. M is equals to V naught by V. And y is the depth of water. Y is the depth of water. If the amount of water is more, then y increases. If the amount of water is less, then the y decreases. If whenever the value of y is more, there is a more problem for our canal, that too in unlined canal. Next, here we need to determine the area. Area, you all know the discharge by velocity. Velocity is nothing but critical mean velocity. Area can be found out by using v plus n into y into y. Here n is the side slope of the canal and y is the depth of water. And what is p? P is nothing but the perimeter of the canal surface. Wetted perimeter of the canal surface is represented by P. P is equals to P plus 2y square root of n square plus 1. And what is R? Usually you, all these things you have studied in your hydraulics. R is nothing but the hydraulic mean depth. Hydraulic mean depth, it is the ratio of area of the canal by wetted perimeter. Hydraulic mean depth is the ratio of area of the canal by hydraulic wetted perimeter. V equals to C into square root of R into S. C is the constant. We can call it as Chesney's constant or Cooter's constant. And S is the side slope. And S is the side slope. And R is the hydraulic mean depth. Here for finding out C, there is a formula. 23 plus 0.00155 plus 1 by N by S. Again 1 plus 23 plus 0.00155 by S. Bracket of N by square root of R. This, by using this formula, you can find out the value of C. This is how we are going to calculate the actual velocity. V is nothing but, V naught is the critical mean velocity, and V is the actual velocity. V is the actual velocity. And Kennedy's theories have some of the limitations. Some of the limitations are here, we will not consider the ratio of B by D. B by D ratio, you will not consider. Kennedy's theories have some of the limitations. One of the limitations are, here only I will write, the limitations are, here you will not consider the ratio of B by D is not considered, and the value of M, as I said, what is M? M is nothing but the critical velocity ratio. Critical velocity ratio, it is an, for a different, value of M is arbitrary. Here the value of M is arbitrary. If you obtain this much velocity, the value of M is this much. If you obtain the value of V is this much and V naught is this much, for that velocity will get the M, because the value of M is arbitrary. And silt charges are constant. Here you are going to say, yes, assume that usually the silt will be, here in Kennedy, silt grade and silt charges are not considered. Silt grade and silt charges are not considered. Silt grade and silt charges are not considered in Kennedy's theory. Here the Kennedy's theory is used to design only for average regime. Average, what is regime? Regime is nothing but it is either the surface of the canal will not score or it will not silt. The silting and scoring will not express. Here it is designed for average regime only. These are some of the limitations in the Kennedy's theory. In Kennedy's theory, it is used to find out the average mean velocity, and it is also used to find out the longitudinal slope of the canal. To overcome this Kennedy's theory, Lace is proposed a new theory for unlined canal whenever the bottom surface is unlined. Lace is also proposed. Lace is also one of the engineer in Rajasthan or Uttar Pradesh. He was an irrigation department engineer. He also proposed an equation to find out the velocity and side slope, or velocity or longitudinal slope. He has proposed one theory called Lace's theory. Lace's theory is quite famous. V equals to QF square by 140 whole power of 1 by 6. Here F is silt factor. F is the silt factor, amount of silt deposited from one place to another place. And what is Q? Q, you all know that Q is nothing but the discharge, and V is nothing but the actual velocity. Next, how we are going to find out the silt factor? Silt factor can be found out because all these theories are an empirical formula. So here we need to bias this formula. Sometimes what you will do in question, directly will give the value of silt factor. If in question, if it does not mention the value of silt factor, then you need to find out the value of silt factor. F is equals to 1.76 square root of D. Here the value of D should be in mm. D is nothing but the diameter of the small particle. It is represented in mm. D should be represented in mm, but here all it should be represented in meter cube per second. And what is P? You all know that P is nothing but the wetted perimeter. P is nothing but the wetted perimeter. P is nothing but the wetted perimeter. Wetted perimeter equals to 4.75 square root of Q. Q is nothing but discharge. Another way is to find out P equals to B plus 2y. B plus 2y square root of n square plus 1. Square root of n square plus 1. And you all know that A is the area of the canal. Area of the canal equals to discharge by velocity. Discharge by velocity. A equals to B plus n into y into y, where n is nothing but the side slope of the canal. N is nothing but the side slope of the canal. One vertical is to n horizontal. Okay, now what is S? Our ultimate aim is to find out, one is mean velocity, another one is longitudinal slope. If you provide this much slope, the canal will not undergo any scoring or silting. The canal will be in safe condition. So if you want to propose our canal should be safe, what should be the longitudinal slope? S equals to f power 5 by 3, f power 5 by 3 divided by 3340 into q power of 1 by 6, into q power of 1 by 6. This is the side slope, or it is the slope. If you want to find out the score depth, what is score depth? Now let us consider it is a canal. At one particular area, there will be heavy flood. At that time, what will happen? The canal, the bottom of the canal will score. If you want to find out the score depth is nothing but 1.35 bracket square root of q square by f. Q square is nothing but discharge by f whole power of 1 by 3. It is the score depth. This much amount of soil is removed from that canal. It is nothing but the score depth. This is how we need to find out the velocity and longitudinal slope of the canal. Here also, Lacy's theories will also have some of the limitations. What are the limitations of Lacy's theory? Here the theory does not give clear picture of the problem. Clear picture of the problem. Here we will not get the exact value of slope, or we will not get the exact mean velocity. There will be some of the defects in there. The second limitation is whatever the slope and whatever the velocity will depends upon the single silt factor. Depends upon the single silt factor. Because you all know that the canal will run for kilometers. Throughout the kilometers of length, we cannot consider same silt factor, because throughout the length of the canal, the soil may change. At one particular area, there is some type of soil. At another particular area, the soil is different. Whenever the soil changes, whenever the intensity of water changes, the silt factor does not remain same. The deposition of silt will also changes. So here we are going to consider the single silt factor. It is also one of the limitations of Lacy's theory. Lacy's theory does not include the concentration of silt. Here will not include the concentration of silt. Like Lacy's theory is suitable only for semi-elliptical shape, whereas the Kennedy's theory is suitable for trapezoidal shape. Kennedy's theory is only suitable for trapezoidal shape, whereas the Lacy's theory is suitable for semi-elliptical shape. And here you will not define properly the silt grade. Here we will not decide properly the silt grade and silt charges. Silt charges. You will not decide all these factors. You will not decide properly. These are some of the limitations of Lacy's theories and Kennedy's theory. Okay, we shall solve one problem regarding Lacy's theories. write down the question. Design an irrigation channel in an alluvial soil according to Lacey's silt theory. For the following data. The full supply discharge is 30 cumac. The next one is the Lacey's silt factor F equals to 1. The side slope of the canal is half horizontal and 1 vertical. Now we should solve the problem. Question. Usually this type of question is usually asked in July 2020, 2 to 3 times he has asked in the question paper for 8 marks in VTU examination. First write down the given. The given is Q. Q is nothing but the discharge is 30 cumac. And silt factor F he has given. What is the silt factor? F equals to 1. Next he has given side slope. The side slope of the canal is 0.5 horizontal, 1 vertical. He has asked us to find out the longitudinal slope. He has also said use the Lacey's theory. Okay. From the Lacey's theory, we all know that V is nothing but the velocity, or actual velocity is equals to Q F square by 140 volt to the power of 1/6. What is the value of Q? It is 30. And what is the value of F? It is 1 square by 140 volt power of 1/6. If you substitute, you will get the value of V equals to 0.7736 meter per second. It is the V. Next, you all know you have found out the V. Next, the step 2 is you need to find out the area. Area equals to Q by V. What is the value of Q? Q, you all know that it is 30. And what is the V? It is 0.7736. If you substitute, you'll get the value of A equals to 38.78 meter square. Okay. Now, what is step 3? Is perimeter. P equals to 4.75 square root of Q. As I said in Lacey's theorem, 4.75 Q is 30. If you substitute, you will get the value of P. P equals to 26. You will get around 26 meter. P equals to 26 meter. Now here we need to decide the width of the canal and depth of the canal. Here we need to find out the value of B, and here we need to find out the value of D. In question is given 1:0.5 is given. Here we need to calculate the B and D. Here we know the value of area. Here we know the value of perimeter. From that we can find out the value of B and D. What is area equation? A equals to BD plus, what is A? BD plus 2 into of N D into D equals to BD plus 2 into 1 by 2 is nothing but it is N D into D. D into D. Here 2 will get cancelled, and what is the value of N? Here the value of N is 0.5. BD plus 0.5 D square. Here the value of A is 38.78. Consider it is an equation 1. Now we all know that P equals to 26 meter. What is the equation for P? P equals to B plus D square root of N square plus 1 into 2. Here the value of N is 0.5. If you substitute P equals to B plus square root of 5D. B plus square root of 5D. And what is the value of P? P equals to 26. Square root of 5 is 2.24. B plus 2.24D. Consider it as an equation 2. Now what you should do is bring the B out. Bring the B out. B equals to 26 minus 2.24D. 2.24D. It is equation 3. Substitute the value of B in equation 1. Substitute equation 3 in 1. Here we know that B equals to 26 minus 2.24D. Here in terms of B, here you substitute to D. 38.78. And what is the value of B? 26 minus 2.24 D bracket D. Again here it is 0.5 D square. 0.5 D square. Because you can edit this term as B. If you cross multiply that, you will get one value. That value is nothing but you will get one equation. D square minus 26D plus 38.78 equals to 0. If you solve the equation in your calc, you will get the value of D equals to 13.26 and 1.68. In these two terms, consider the value of D equals to D is the lower of the two. Here the lower one value is 1.68. D equals to 1.68 meter. The D equals to 1.68 meter. Here you know the equation B equals to 26 minus 2.24 D. 26 minus 2.24 into 1.68. If you substitute, you will get the value of B. B equals to 22.23 meter. B equals to 22.23 meter. 22.23 meter we have obtained. Next, what we need to find out? Slope. slope equals to, what is the equation for slope? Slope f 5 by 3 3340 q 1 power 6. What is the value of f? It is 1. And what is the value of q? It is 30 power 1 power 6. If you substitute, you will get the value of s as s equals to 1 by 5890. S equals to 1 by 5890. You are this slope here, we need to provide the equation. At this slope here, we need to provide the equation. At last, what you should do is, you need to draw one big diagram, and there you need to represent the value of B and value of D. There you need to represent the side slope, and there you need to also represent the longitudinal slope. Whatever the answer you will get, you will get 5890. For that 5890, here you need to divide it with 1. You need to represent it. Whatever the answer you will get is 5890. But what we should do is, the slope will be in 1 in n. So it will be 1 by 5890. Should represent in 1 by 5890. Actually, I am guest paruthe andre illa 5890 paruthe. But it should represent in 1 in n. It is nothing but 1 by 5890. It is this slope. Here the D value is 1.68 and the B value is 22.23. And longitudinal slope is 1 by 5890. This type of problem is asked for 8 marks, approximately 3 to 4 times he has asked. The only thing is, you need to remember the formula. V equals to QF square by 140 over power of 1 by 6. Again, A equals to Q by V. Next P is nothing but the perimeter equals to 4.75 square root of Q. And A equals to BD plus 2 into 1 by 2 ND into D square. BD plus 0.5 D square. And P equals to B plus bracket D into square root of N square plus 1. Again, it is multiplied with 2. Here the value of N is 0.5. If you substitute, you will get the value as square root of 5. What is the value of square root of 5? It is nothing but 2.24. What you should do is, bring B out and 26 inside, you will get one equation. Equation 3 is B equals to 26 minus 2.24 D. Substitute the B value in this equation 1, you will get one equation. Solve the equation by using your calci, you will get the value of D. Whatever the value D should be, D should not be negative, and should consider D value of lesser 1. You will get 2 D value. Both the D values are positive. In that positive values, here we need to consider the lesser 1. That is the depth of the channel, or the depth of the canal is 1.68. From that, you are going to find out the width. After that, you are going to find out the longitudinal slope. The maximum you can change is discharge, or you can change is side slope. Everything remains same. This type of problem will be asked for short question in VTU examination. Okay, thank you.